Charlie's very existence proves, in fact, there must be some intelligent form of life on Thasus. He could not possibly have survived alone. The ship's food concentrates would have been exhausted in a year or so.
By which time he would have been eating fruits, vegetables,
probes of Thasus indicate very little animal
life. And probes have been known to be wrong,
Doctor, are you speaking scientifically or emotionally?
Gentlemen.
Your pulse is 242. Your blood pressure is practically non-existent. Assuming you call that green stuff in your veins blood.
The readings are perfectly normal for me, Doctor. Thank you. And as for my anatomy being different from yours, I am delighted.
Jim, you can't risk your life on a theory.
Being split in two halves is no theory with me, Doctor. I have a human half, you see, as well as an alien half, submerged, constantly at war with each other. Personal experience, Doctor. I survive it because my intelligence wins out over both, makes them live together.
That fella sounded a mite upset, didn't he?
Yes. Yes, they are.
Curious. I'm happy the affair is over. A most annoying, emotional episode.
Smack right in the old eye. Oh, I'm sorry. In your case, it would be about here.
The fact that my internal arrangement differs from yours, Doctor, pleases me no end.
Bones. Why do you think the symptoms haven't appeared on Mr. Spock?
I don't know. Probably the little bugs or whatever they are. I have no appetite for green blood.
Being a red-blooded human obviously has its disadvantages. And there you have a museum piece, Doctor. Lens type, manually operated, light activated.
Spare me the analysis, Mr. Spock, please. It's enough that it works.
Is he dead, Mr. Spock?
Not yet. Interesting. The Earth people glorify organized violence for 40 centuries. But you imprison those who employ it privately.
And of course, your people found an answer.
You disposed of emotion, Doctor. Where there's no emotion, there's no motive for violence.
He would not make a false entry.
There's a false entry in the log right now which doesn't jibe with the established facts. How do you explain that?
I can't, but to question Spock of all people. Me, yes. I could run off half-cocked given a good reason. So could you. But not Spock. That's impossible.
Mr. Spock, the man on top walks along his street. The chain of command is often a noose.
Spare me your philosophical metaphors, Doctor. Captain is acting strangely. I'm asking if you've noticed.
Negative. You know, this is the first time in a week that I've had time for a drop of the truth. Would you care for a drink, Mr. Spock?
My father's race was spared the dubious benefits of alcohol.
Oh. Now I know why they were conquered. What are you so worried about anyway? I find Jim generally knows what he's doing.
It was illogical for him to bring those players aboard.
Illogical? Did you get a look at that little Juliet? That's a pretty exciting creature. Of course, your personal chemistry would prevent you from seeing that. Did it ever occur to you that he simply might like the girl?
It occurred. I dismissed it.
You would?
Did you know that he suddenly transferred Lieutenant Riley to engineering?
Lots of things are going around here that I don't know, Mr. Spock. Now, he's the captain. He can transfer people as he pleases. You can look that up in 100 volumes of space regulations somewhere, all right? All right. Now, come on, have a drink.
No, thank you.
Well, you're welcome. But I will. And please, Mr. Spock, if you won't join me, don't disapprove of me. At least not until you've tried it, huh?
All right. Someone tried to kill him.
Could have been an accident.
You should be told the difference between empiricism and stubbornness, Doctor. I checked with the library computer, just as you did. I got the same information.
Aren't you getting a little out of line, Mr. Spock? My personal business...
It is my personal business when it might interfere with the smooth operation of this ship.
You think that happened?
It could happen.
I don't like anyone meddling in my private affairs, not even my second in command.
Jim, Spock's simply trying to...
I know what he's trying to do, and I don't like it.
It's his job, and you know it.
I agree. Attack.
Are you suggesting we fight to prevent a fight?
Based on what? Memories of a war over a century ago? On theories about a people we've never even met face to face?
We know what they look like.
Yes, indeed we do, Mr. Stiles. And if the Romulans are an offshoot of my Vulcan blood, and I think this likely, then attack becomes even more imperative.
War is never imperative, Mr. Spock.
It is for them, Doctor. Vulcan, like Earth, had its aggressive, colonizing period. Savage, even by Earth standards. And if the Romulans retain this martial philosophy, then weakness is something we dare not show.
Do you want a galactic war on your conscience?
Dr. McCoy, a reading on the atmosphere, please.
Partial pressure of oxygen, 70 millimeters of mercury. Nitrogen, 140. Breathable, if you're not running in competition.
Just the facts, Doctor.
Traces of argon, neon, krypton. All in acceptable quantities. However, I wouldn't recommend this place as a summer resort.
Thank you for your opinion. It will be duly noted. You're recording this, Yeoman?
Well, I can't say much for the circumstances, but at least it's your big chance.
A big chance? For what, Doctor?
Command. Oh, I know you, Mr. Spock. You've never voiced it, but you've always thought that logic was the best basis on which to build command. Am I right?
I am a logical man, Doctor.
Well, it'll take more than logic to get us out of this.
Perhaps, Doctor, but I know of no better way to begin. I realize that command does have its fascinations, even under circumstances such as these. But I neither enjoy the idea of command, nor am I frightened of it. It simply exists. And I will do whatever logically needs to be done. Excuse me.
No, go back! Lift off! Go back! No!
We couldn't leave you out there.
Gentlemen, by coming after me, you may well have destroyed what slim chance you had for your survival. The logical thing for you to have done was to have left me behind.
Mr. Spock, remind me to tell you that I'm sick and tired of your logic.
That is the most illogical attitude.
Mr. Spock, you said a while ago that there were always alternatives.
Did I? I may have been mistaken.
Well, at least I've lived long enough to hear that.
The precise meaning of the word desert is a waterless, barren wasteland. I fail to understand your romantic nostalgia for such a place.
Doesn't surprise me, Mr. Spock. I can't imagine a mirage ever disturbing those mathematically perfect brainwaves of yours.
Thank you, Dr. McCoy. It may be unappetizing, Doctor, but it is very logical.
Oh, there's that magic word again. Does your logic find this fascinating, Mr. Spock?
Well, fascinating is a word I use for the unexpected. In this case, I should think interesting would suffice. Perhaps, Captain, but nevertheless,
I... Spock, isn't it enough the Commodore is famous for his hospitality? I, for one, could use a good non-reconstituted meal.
Doctor, you are a sensualist.
You bet your pointed ears I am. Ready whenever you are, Captain.
But in our society, he'd be useless. A kick. But maybe he could be retrained, re-educated. Now you're sounding like Spock.
If you're gonna get nasty, I'm gonna leave.
Poor photography.
Blast your theories and observations, Mr. Spock. What about Jim? He's down there alone, probably under arrest. He doesn't have a communicator, and we can't locate him or beam him back aboard without one.
I am aware of that, Doctor.
How long have they been down there now?
15 minutes, 28 seconds.
Well, shouldn't they be coming up?
It
It is a fact, Doctor, that prowling by stealth is more time-consuming than a direct approach. In our case, a...
Shouldn't you be working on your time warp calculations, Mr. Spock?
I am.
Well, I had to see it to believe it.
Explain.
They're about to lop off the captain's professional head, and you're sitting here playing chess with a computer.
That is true.
Mr. Spock, you're the most cold-blooded man I've ever known.
Why, thank you, Doctor. I've just won my fourth game.
That's impossible.